one of the things that recently happened in the United States I want to bring to your attention. Those of you who have gone to Las Vegas, Nevada, have recently witnessed where they have built a replica, or tried to build a replica, of Horemakhet, one of the most ancient colossals, not only built right here on the African continent, but the most ancient colossal on the planet Earth. And they made him with blue eyes and white skin. And not one word is said that this is an African architectural structure. And even put a pyramid, and they even have Tut's hut.
Right.
So the sad thing is that people from all over the world go here, and not one word is mentioned that this is an African architectural structure. Not one word is mentioned that this belongs to African people. And the sad thing is that many Africans who go there and spend their money don't even realize it themselves. And the rooms are called Tut's hut. As Dr. John Henry Clark, another grandmaster teacher of ours, would say, that which is sacred to us has been desecrated. And not only has it been desecrated, but we have been taught to laugh at its desecration. That's a shame. All people who are a people must preserve their ancient sites. For us to be a people, we must have something that is ancient that belongs to us. So when you look up at the face of Horemakhet, you can see where Napoleon, who came here in 1798 and had 21 cannons, his generals, line up 21 cannons and blow the nose off. And George Washington, who was part of the Illuminati, Benjamin Franklin, and Andrew Jackson. That's why they named Memphis, Tennessee, off of Menephra, Memphis, where we're going in a few minutes, trying to design from the Grand Masters. So they know they were stealing the people from the African continent and stealing the knowledge as well. So let's go up on the high wall and see more of Horemakhet and deal more in depth with the history, the true history of this Grand Master who came up out of pre-dynastic Egypt. Not the fourth dynasty, but pre-dynastic, who was part of the real Horus King, who was deified as a god. The first deification as God as a man.
Tell it, brother. Tell it like it is, man.
Tell it, brother.
Horemakhet.
This is something, something to behold. Mm-hmm.
Oh, your trip, it hasn't even begun yet.
I know. I just
went to America and brainwashed the people to death.
Well, how do you keep a people slaves?
That's right.
You got to take away their story. You got to take away what is sacred to them, and then you desecrate it. So, brothers and sisters, you are at one of the most spectacular sites right here, and that is Horemakhet, who the Greeks call the Sphinx, over 240 feet long and over 65 feet high. Keep in mind, if you look at his ears, 6 feet tall, that means you can stand inside of his ears.
Wow.
Look how massive this colossal is. Standing here from the dawn of time, who the Arabs call him Abu Hal, or meaning the great father. And truly the great father of time. And now, through documentation and excavations, some have even documented that Horemakhet may go back to the time of the Badarian Age. Reconstruction have taken place down through the ages. Many European Egyptologists have said that this is Khafra of the fourth dynastic period. But if you look at the prognathous jaw, he looks nothing like Khafra. Let's go and see, as I said, in pre-dynastic times, representing the Shimsu Heru, let's go back and see who Horemakhet goes back to. With a little twa, who our ancestors, even known as the Sebenetos,
yes,
who was during that time of the pre-dynastic period known as the Twa and even Bes, that's where you see his origins go back to, who the Africans built this. So here we have all proof and documentation of where the origin of Horemakhet, and all who comes before him, like the Europeans you see here, have to look up at this and see the beginning. When Napoleon was documented in Los Angeles Times, that when Napoleon visited the Sphinx in 1798, everything but the head had been buried in sand, although his soldiers reputedly used the head for target practice. But we know it's a new day today, and it's the first day today. So you may not grasp where you have been until you go back and lay your eyes down and Horemakhet come into your sleep. When Horemakhet digs deep down into your what they call REM sleep, and come up and said, you came back to visit me. But here you, where the kings came between the pole, where you get the Grand Master's grip of the